Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back to the Too Hype channel. Today, we have a very, very, very special video for you guys. Too Hype Shocked. I am gonna be your host, Zachary London, followed by my brother, Christopher London.
Hello.
Hello, your favorite judge is back.
And our third and final judge. Some of you guys have never met before. His name is Jesse Rigatoni.
Hello, hello.
I'm glad to be a judge with you guys.
Awesome.
Thank you for coming all the way from Italy, Mr. Rigatoni. Our three contestants are gonna be cooking against each other. They're gonna have to use all the ingredients that are in their special baskets. I'm gonna bring contestants out right now. Our first contestant today, James.
Thank God, I'm out of the stench-filled room of the other contestants.
Chef James.
How's it going, Chef Judge Zack?
So I've cooked for multiple Michelin star restaurants, and I'm best known for teaching Gordon Ramsay how to cook.
That's a cap.
Our next contestant, the chicken nugget boy himself, MOPI.
So when I heard MOPI was a contestant, I wasn't that worried about him, trust me.
Oh, the lights.
Oh, the lights, they're so bright.
Hey,
you fucking suck at cooking.
I cook chicken tenders mostly, just throw them in the microwave real quick. That's my specialty.
Are those dinosaur?
Of course.
Respect.
And our third contestant in tonight's Chopped episode is one of your favorites, Chef Oh Nasty.
Chef Oh Nasty.
All the way from the swamps of Louisiana.
He's neighbors with Shrek.
All right, Chef Oh Nasty, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, from Louisiana down south, we put a lot of seasoning on our food. We cook alligator, pigs, hogs.
Coons.
Coons.
Woo.
What? Raccoon.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. All right, we've met the contestants. Now, let's see what they're gonna be working with tonight.
Contestants, reveal.
Your first item.
Contestants, first
sausages.
Item.
Sausages.
Okay. Some chicken apple sausage. Nope. That is the first ingredient. Next item.
Corn.
We have some corn on the cob. Next item, contestants. We have some green and red peppers with some onions. All right, next item.
Cookies.
Chocolate chip cookies. And the last item that you must use in your dish is
an apple.
A nice, shiny red apple.
I see the ingredients, I see peppers, I see sausage, instantly thinking sausage and peppers. My mom used to make it. Saw mozzarella cheese out of the corner of my eye, I said, time to make a sub.
All right, if you guys are not familiar with the rules of Chopped, they have to use the ingredients, those five ingredients that are set out there, but they can use anything else in the kitchen, pantry, fridge, freezer, anything that they want to make their dishes.
It just must include the secret ingredients.
They must have the secret ingredients in their dish. All right, contestants, you've had time to plan your dishes. You know your ingredients, and you know all the extras that you can use. Are you ready?
Yes.
You're gonna have 30 minutes to prepare your dishes. Begin in 3, 2, 1.
Whose dish are you most excited for straight away?
Well, I'm actually quite intrigued with Chef Oh Nasty. But MOPI is the one I'm gonna be looking out for.
Okay.
What ideas do you got so far?
Right now, I'm going with, I'm trying to take a basic, simple, much like I see some barbecue sausage and chicken. I'm gonna use that with the fajita mix. I'm gonna try to cook something up from that.
So MOPI, what are you looking to accomplish by moving your corn?
You'll see.
We got James with a big knife over here chopping up.
Oh. Jesus.
No, that's what I call chop.
We have Chef Oh Nasty adding a little more protein to the meal.
I like it. Okay. He looks like he loves his protein.
You know, word on the street is he loves meat. I saw a tweet that he loves, sometimes he slaps it, but that's like, he's like a weird fetish.
Is he the one that says he has a fetish with the raw meat?
Yes.
Bruh.
Oh, MOPI's also bringing out some more protein.
MOPI's bringing out chicken too.
Now there's already a protein in the secret ingredient.
Yeah, there is sausage that they have to include, so.
I decided to go with the chicken and the sausage because I like to make chicken myself. I like to think I'm pretty good at it.
That's a big piece.
No. I don't want it anymore.
Mate, you gotta commit.
Chef Oh Nasty stole James's knife.
Wait, bro, what the fuck? Wait, you're cutting chicken with that?
Looks like you're gonna have to wash it off, mate.
I seen a knife just sitting there, and I took it and I
swap that with my dad would do.
Now that is a large piece of chicken. He does realize he only has 25 more minutes to cook that.
Mate, you've been seasoning that for fucking 12 minutes. Do something.
Don't do that.
Okay.
Don't yell at me.
You've been seasoning that raw chicken for 10 minutes.
Seasoning is everything.
Oh, whoa.
Someone follow that man.
We're gonna have to go with MOPI.
He's the only one in this house that has used that grill. Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna go out there and check on MOPI at the grill.
We got Chef MOPI out here on the grill. Judges, what do you guys think? I didn't know this grill worked. I've tried to use it once, and I came back into the regular kitchen because I couldn't figure it out.
So I see you seem to be making some sort of nice mixture here with the sausage and the sauce. What served as inspiration for this?
When I lived back east, subs, Philly cheesesteaks were kind of all the rage, so I'm really kind of going for that here. And my got a lot of like East Coast American cooking.
Now, very interesting contrast, Cash. This is a lot more minimalist.
I'm more about quality. So what I'm doing right now, I'm going to make sure I get all the flavors I can. What I got.
Now, if you were to place early bets on who you think is going to be the chef.
You know, as the two-light chop champion, I'm liking what I'm seeing from Cash right now. He actually has stuff on the grill. MOPI spent 10 minutes trying to turn
Cash
on the grill.
Cash is sabotaging. He put a raw thing on my cutting board.
Judge, can I get a ref?
That's tough.
No, that's not tough. He's contaminating my food, bro. That's literally cheating.
What
the fuck
is going on here?
He put his raw meat knife on my food.
Wait, we're not here, you know, health inspecting. We're just judging.
We just want good food.
Chicken is cooking quite nicely, Cash.
Thank you, sir.
I actually cook this every single day. You wouldn't believe it.
Dang, what kind of seasoning you got on there?
Well, I got some Himalayan salt. I don't like table salt. I feel like Himalayan salt actually give a better taste.
I'm worried about MOPI. He hasn't touched three of his ingredients.
Now, MOPI, are you feeling the time crunch a little now that some of your other contestants are cooking inside?
This is so bad. I don't know what I'm doing.
Now, in the past, you've described yourself to me as a wiener pro. Do you think that holds up here?
I don't know what you're talking about. Right now, I'm working on my dessert portion and the shells of the subs I'm making.
Oh, subs!
Okay, we got James. Oh my God. Dipping the apple in cinnamon?
Cinnamon, yeah.
And putting it in a baking dish.
Little does he know, I'm allergic to cinnamon.
So we've got, okay, that chicken.
I don't know.
How is it gonna cook, bro?
I don't know if anyone should eat that.
We might have to do some movie magic with that one.
Oh, that's a lot of
chocolate. That might be a I don't know about that one.
I'm not sure where he's going with this. He's got chocolate sauce on the cookies, cinnamon on the apples, and it's in a baking dish.
I thought about those cookies you see at delis where it's like half covered in chocolate on one side, it adds that nice element. I'm like, I'm gonna do that, put some chocolate on it, throw it in the freezer.
Chef Onasi, tell me, what's going on here?
Well, we're gonna fix y'all guys up some nice.
Ooh, he's using some lime. Now, this is a little different because when we saw Chef MOPI preparing his corn on the cob, he just threw it into the tinfoil.
It looks like the grill was not coming through for MOPI. He's transferred inside. Little does he know, we are halfway done.
That chicken is not halfway done, mate.
Oh, he's eating.
Did you see
it
that?
It makes me uncomfortable.
Did anyone catch that?
Chef James is eating his meal while he prepares it.
So now, I gotta make some of the apple.
Like what?
I don't know.
Now, MOPI, considering you got about 10 more minutes left, how are you feeling?
We have 10 minutes left?
Roughly.
That's so bad.
Chef James is really doing something over there.
Oh. He's going crazy.
If you were to guess, who has it right now?
Jidel. Chef Jidel, I love what I'm seeing. He seems to know exactly what he's doing. And a lot of people, I see a lot of thinking, a lot of standing still, a lot of disappointment.
Now, are you excited to see what MOPI has to offer?
No. I feel like MOPI has the absolute worst time management when it comes to cooking.
100%. I feel like he cannot focus on more.
Focus on your bloody meal, mate!
I'm not gonna lie, my time management is pretty garbage. I procrastinate, I put things off, I forget about things, so when it comes to cooking, that's not good.
I have an idea to give you some inspiration.
I don't need your inspiration. Suck it, I'm a win.
Alright, well then go fuck yourself.
MOPI, you're still outside.
Oh! He's forgotten about the grill!
Cooking is all about multitasking.
It's fine. The wieners are fine.
So I'm having a little problem. The grill is actually cooking too slow, so I think my corn is a little still a bit cold.
Chris, come here. Does this look raw, or is it just me in the middle? What's going on with this chicken? Look at the inside. That looks raw to me.
It's still cooking.
That's medium salmonella.
Now, is this why everyone in high school called you Wiener Boy?
I'm not gonna lie. I thought this was just a time challenge, not me trying to cook while getting harassed by the judges. I thought that was really unfair. I definitely felt like I was being targeted.
I think MOPI has forgot to blend the fucking blender.
He's letting it soak.
First, the salmonella chicken.
Oh my god! His sausage is rolling around on the dirty table I've seen people sit on.
On the Venus Island, mate!
Bro, you did not see that.
You're not slick!
Oh, you are. Oh, this is sad.
You know what? Let's let the man work.
How's that caramel looking?
Bro, it's starting to come together.
That's starting to look like caramel.
It really is.
Oh, he's at the apple. He left the sticker on. He's cutting the sticker. This is actually sad.
Wait,
please. Is he just? Oh, God. Oh my goodness. He's dropped apple slices into the milkshakes. Just drop.
Jesus. We haven't seen that in Chopped history.
Now, do you know which corn is yours and which?
No, I do not.
Are you worried you're gonna get Mopi's corn?
Yes.
I think Mopi's chicken still needs an extra 15 minutes. So, not judges. What do we rule on that?
I mean, it wasn't even a secret ingredient, so he's just gonna have to leave it off his meal.
Yeah, I don't know why he even started.
If he serves that, it's an auto loss.
Now, some of the judges have been calling you a failure.
That's so harsh.
30 seconds, chef!
Now, we are judging on presentation two.
15 seconds, chef!
He's using spray on butter.
10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Take your hands away from the plate.
Hands off.
Oh, fuck me.
Our first plate, Chef O Nasty, what have you prepared for us?
Well, today I try to mix in like basically a dish what I would eat every single day. With a little bit more zest and flavor in it.
You've definitely improved since last episode.
Also, you guys see the dessert in front of you guys is supposed to be a mix with a hot cookie with a cold dessert on top of it.
Mate, the peanut butter with the apple, was that just because you had to use it, or is that something you do down south, or what was going on? Because I've seen peanut butter on celery, but not an apple.
I actually eat it with an apple.
I respect it. I'm just asking if it was, you know, from where I'm from. I've never seen it before.
Is it bad to eat the seed of an apple?
I'm gonna try this here first.
Mm. That's cool. Mm. I like that. The sausage cooked perfectly.
Mm. Oh. All right.
Guess I'll try the apple first.
Apple?
Apple.
Make sure you bite it too with the peanut butter.
With the.
Ooh.
Is there sugar on that apple?
Yes, sir.
Peanut butter threw me off completely. Well, Chef O Nasty, when I saw this cookie, when there was about 15 minutes left, when you originally put it onto the plate, it looked delicious. I'm afraid that hot cold might have hurt you.
I mean, you know what might have hurt you? You're wearing glasses inside of the house.
All right, Chef O Nasty, thank you. The next plate we will be judging will be from Chef James. Chef James, what have you prepared for us tonight?
We got an Italian sausage and peppers with fresh basil sub, corn on the cob, a 4th of July staple. You know, to combat the heat, I wanted to go cold with the desserts. So we have chocolate covered cookies, cinnamon covered apples, and we have a freshly prepared caramel dipping sauce for the apples.
Oh, fresh.
Yes.
You made this
yourself.
You made this
caramel sauce.
Now that, I've had a lot of caramel in my life and I is never looked
because this one has some cinnamon in it.
Oh!
It's thick caramel.
Oh, it's very thick.
It's that time to cool.
Oh man.
Oh. Am I doing the fucking cinnamon challenge, mate?
I see the apple hit Zach's mouth, Jesse's mouth, Chris' mouth, and my heart sinks. I know I put too much cinnamon on.
Fucking spoonful of cinnamon, mate!
Fuck, mate!
That's a lot of cinnamon. Fuck! My teeth are stuck together from the caramel sauce!
Mmm. You know,
Oh, that chocolate is strong. Right, I think chocolate would have been nice, but not chocolate syrup.
His corn was cooked differently than Chef Onassis, but it seems like he did put salt on his.
I am in love with this. I'm more a big flavor. Fan of Italian sausage sandwiches, and this one hits different.
The sub does seem to hit differently.
Yes.
As you can tell, I'm not talking very much.
We'll take a quick break and finish the fuck out of this meal, and we'll be right back.
Next up, we've got Mopi.
You mean Chef Mopi?
I refuse to use that word next to the name.
I wouldn't. Chef Mopi! What have you prepared for us this evening?
Today I have prepared for you. We got some corn on the cob, sausage on the side, peppers next to the sausage and corn. And then to finish it off for dessert, we have a very nice cookie milkshake with an apple inside.
Alright, so how I'd like to start by digging into this.
Excuse me. I need to talk about that. Don't do that.
First of all, the look of this meal, this is abysmal.
I feel like none of them foods complement each other. They're all just thrown in.
Mate, it looks like a fucking rabbit ate all me vegetables.
Where are the onions?
I have them, mate.
Right. You have all the onions.
I don't have any red peppers.
I have no green peppers, mate.
This is a milkshake with a slice of an apple just shoved it.
He just dropped it in there.
Am I supposed to drink the apple or do I pick it out?
No, you pick it out and then eat the apple first. That is supposed to be the entry to the dessert. You enjoy the apple first, then the milkshake itself.
Mate, try the apple.
I would insist you try the milkshake covered apple.
Mmm. That might be the best apple I've had.
You might be onto something, mate.
That's pretty good. I'm gonna try the milkshake as well. The milkshake is actually...
What's the face for, Judge?
Mate, it's straight water. Do we...
I insist you take a bite, yes.
This corn is abysmal.
Wait a minute.
I'm not gonna lie, the flavor might be the best sausage when you get the
dessert. That's what I'm talking about.
I think he does have the most flavorful sausage. But I will say that.
But you can only eat about a third of it.
Holy.
This was a short meal. Who would have guessed?
Boys,
oh my God.
Would you like to follow me?
Yes, actually. Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, usually we will reveal who has been chopped, but on this episode, we're just gonna get Mopi the hell out of the way because that was terrible.
When I got chopped, I thought that was the most disrespectful way they could have gone about doing it, so I don't know if I want to return on the show. I don't really appreciate the judges doing that, and I'm kind of just done with cooking in general.
It's down to Chef James and Chef Onasty.
Let's start off, who had the better dessert?
I think I might have bombed my chances with the dessert. They were not liking
what
it.
Happened? Yeah, they liked the meal, though. They liked
what
the
happened
meal
with the chocolate?
I'm gonna be honest, because of the cinnamon, my vote has to go to Kosh.
Yeah, I'm gonna go Chef Onasty with the dessert.
I'm also the one Chef Onasty, because Jidel's cookie was... Quite honestly, it was
a cookie
disgusting
with disgusting chocolate sauce on it. The apple, way too much cinnamon.
Yeah, Mopi, I'm not gonna lie, I looked up like two times to see what you were doing, and all I saw was like you running. I never saw you in one place.
I was not very sure what I was doing a lot of the time, so there was a lot of confusion going back and forth.
Now on to the main course, the sausage and corn.
It was a great meal. Fit the theme, used all the ingredients mm-hmm beautifully.
The creativity of Chef Onasty chopping up the chicken, mixing it with the sausage, putting the barbecue sauce on it, and sauteing it with the peppers
that,
and onions.
His was delicious.
I'm gonna be honest, mate. I know I may have finished Jidel's meal, but I have to give my vote to Chef Onasty.
I heard you're getting fired from your restaurant job after this?
I've been fired.
Oh, you've been out of work?
Oh, yeah.
Even though Chef Onasty had the better dessert, I just absolutely love that sandwich James prepared, and I ate the whole thing, it's gone. So for that reason, I'm voting Chef Jidel.
So one vote Chef Onasty, one vote Chef Jidel. And ladies and gentlemen, I will make my decision when the contestants return. Chef Mopi, we asked you to leave the premises. We were actually serious about that.
I can't even be the lineup, just let me be the lineup again.
Hey,
all right, Mopi.
You've been chopped.
Just please leave. We're gonna start out with the main meal. James,
yes.
Your main entree
the corn with the salt and the butter, very nice. It was prepared, boiled, which was a little bit different from the grilled that we were expecting, but it was a nice touch, very good flavor. Now your sandwich. That may be one of the best things that we've ever had this show.
How do the French or Italian say it? Bon appetit?
I think they say that before they eat, but. Now, James, your dessert. The apples with the cinnamon on it, that was a lot of, it was literally the cinnamon challenge. It hurt.
Mopi's dessert was better.
My tongue is still
I'm not gonna lie, Mopi's dessert was better. The cookie with the chocolate sauce smeared on it. I like the creativity that you were going for, but it was the wrong type of chocolate. On to you, Chef O'Nasty. We'll start with your main course as well. The corn, grilled to perfection, with the butter and seasoning placed on it before it was grilled.
Wait, with a slight dash of lime.
With the dash of lime.
I love the hint of lime.
Could I call it a sort of a gumbo? A barbecue gumbo, maybe?
Sauteed
gumbo was amazing. I like how you incorporated the peppers and the onions. The chicken, wasn't expecting it.
But it came out phenomenal.
It was a great combo.
Now, onto your dessert. The cookie with the ice cream with the caramel sauce drizzled on top. Now, the cookie got cold. Your intention was to have it warm, served with the cold ice cream. We liked that. It didn't work.
It did not.
But the flavor was there. It was still very good. Now the apple with the sugar sprinkled on top and the peanut butter.
It grew on me.
You actually made him a fan. So, our final decision. Chef James, you've been chopped.
Getting chopped, I kind of felt like it was gonna happen. Cash had a better all-around meal. I really messed up the dessert round. I had it coming to me. I just wanted to lose with class, unlike Mopi.
Now, this decision was very hard. The sandwich was amazing, but it came down to the dessert.
You had the best main meal, but the worst dessert.
Yes, mate. I mean, it hurt me the most, I think, just because of how, I mean, you see my plate.
He finished the sandwich, it's gone.
It's not there.
Well, you know what? Thank you, judges. Best of luck, Chef Cash.
That means the winner of the first Too Hype Chopped, Chef O'Nasty.
Wow. I was ecstatic, man. I was happy the fact they chose me, man. I actually thought I was gonna get ready to rage. I had pants beside me. I was gonna go crazy, but thank you so much for having me on the show.
All right, that's gonna do it, fellas. I hope you enjoyed this week's episode of Chopped on the Too Hype channel, the first ever. Congratulations to Chef O'Nasty.
Now, if you wanna check out our spelling bee, click right here. If you wanna check out our week in the life, click up here and click right here to subscribe. Everyone subscribe.
Make sure you
right
subscribe.
Now.
Thank you guys for watching this episode. Peace.
Yeet.
Where did you come from?
Mopi, what?
Mopi, get out.
Get the fuck out, mate.